Hi Girl Scouts, my name's Annie, and I work for Girl Scouts River Valleys. I work with a program team, specifically outdoor programming, so I love getting Girl Scouts outside. Whether that's rock climbing, or going canoeing on a lake or river, or like we're doing today, we're going to get outside and we're going to cook a meal using the energy from the sun. So, like I said, I work at Girl Scouts River Valleys, which is located in St. Paul, Minnesota. Now, where is St. Paul, Minnesota, you might be wondering? Well, let me show you on a map. Now, my brother made this map when he was in elementary school. He's a pretty talented dude, but he's a lot older now. Anyway, thank you, Josh, for making this map. So, St. Paul, Minnesota is located right there. Now, a little background for you. I was in Girl Scouts way back when. I was a Girl Scout all the way from when I was a little daisy up until I was an ambassador. Now, I asked my Girl Scout friends, who I'm still friends with today, if it was okay if I gave you photo evidence of my Girl Scout experience, and they said yes. So, here you have it. Here is a few of my Girl Scout friends at Camp Lake Hubert in Brainerd, Minnesota. This is Ella and Lila, and yes, we are totally rocking some Girl Scout fanny packs. Now, let me assure you that these fanny packs are just as cool now as they were back then. And yes, we still have them. So today, we are going to be working towards our Junior Eco Camper badge. And the goal of today is to make a pizza box solar cooker. Then, we're going to plan a meal. And then we are going to use the energy from the sun to cook our meal in our cooker. So, to get started, you are going to need at least 1 hour to do this activity. You're also going to need a few materials. The first material being a pizza box. Now, you don't need a specific size pizza box so long as it's a pizza box. And the one thing you are going to want to make sure is that you don't have any leftover pizza in your box. Let's check mine. Okay, no leftover pizza. We ate all of our pizza last night and it was delicious. The next materials you're going to need are a scissors. You're going to need a black marker, a box cutter or a utility knife. You will need either tape or glue, both work just fine. You will need a ruler, a stick of some kind to prop your box up later on, some black construction paper. Now, I didn't have any black construction paper, so I taped some black tissue paper onto a piece of paper. That's gonna work great. You could also take a white piece of paper and color it with a black crayon or a black marker. Some other materials you'll need is some tin foil. And then you also need some plastic wrap. I've got a big box of plastic wrap. Most plastic wrap boxes are smaller, but so long as you have that plastic wrap. And then, last but not least, you are going to need some food to cook. Today, I am going to cook some awesome nachos. Now, it's really important to note here that we ask that you don't cook any meat, poultry, or fish. Now, we ask this because if these foods are undercooked, they can be dangerous to eat. So we'll leave that kind of cooking to more experienced solar cooker chefs. But some other examples of things you could cook would be a s'more. You can make nachos like me, or you could even reheat leftovers. So if you have leftover pizza from your pizza party, then you could reheat that in your solar cooker. So, now that we have all of our materials, we need a little bit of space. Now, I cleared off our kitchen table. That's gonna give me plenty of room to make our pizza box solar cooker. You could also clear off some space on a floor, or even make it outside. Then, once our pizza box solar cooker is constructed, we are going to be taking it outside. So it's important to have a sunny spot that you can place your solar cooker. And you're gonna wanna make sure that you do this on a sunny day because that will make sure that your meal is cooked to perfection. If it's a cloudy day, it doesn't work quite as well. So, Without further ado, let's get started constructing our solar cooker. Our first step is to draw a square on your pizza box lid. Now, be sure to leave about an inch of space between the edge of your pizza box and the square that you're drawing. I'll demonstrate. You're going to want to use your black marker, your ruler, and your pizza box. For this next step, it's really important. You're gonna wanna open your pizza box and see which side of the box, the square you just drew, is closest to the crease. Now, for me, it's this line right here. I'm gonna take my marker and I'm gonna draw a squiggly line through it. Now I know that I'm not going to cut on this squiggly line. Next, we're gonna take our box cutter. Now, it's really important that you have adult supervision or even adult help for this part because using a box cutter is a little dangerous. So you're gonna wanna be careful. Now, for this part, I am going to use the box cutter to cut a line on all of the edges of the square that aren't squiggled. I'll demonstrate. Next, you are going to lift up the piece that you just cut, and you're going to fold it back on the squiggly line that you drew on your pizza box, like this. There. Now you have a little window into your pizza box. For our next step, you are going to want to use tape and plastic wrap. So, I already cut a few pieces of plastic wrap, and you're going to need about two. You're going to place it over the opening, and you're going to use tape to attach the plastic wrap to the edges of the box. I'll demonstrate. So, now that I've sealed the top of my window with saran wrap, I am going to flip it over and I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now, a really important thing to note here is that you want to make sure that the plastic wrap is really tight across and is sealed down at all points. And when I do it on this side, I'm going to make sure that I seal it on this underside as well. I'll demonstrate. Great job so far. So at this point, our pizza box solar cooker should look like this. And for our next step, we are going to use tin foil and tape. Or if you wanted to, you could also use glue. So right now we are going to make the reflector piece to our solar box. We are going to use the shiny side of our tin foil. And we are going to tape or glue it onto this big flap right here. So I'll do that right now. Now your solar cooker should look a little bit like this. And already you can see that it's starting to reflect sun. Whew, that hurts my eyes when I look directly at it, but that's exactly what we want. So now for the next step, you are going to open your pizza box and you are going to put tin foil right here. Make sure it's the shiny side. I'll show you. Great, so now that you have that done, this is what your pizza box solar cooker should look like. It should have a reflective flap here, the plastic wrap here to create that window, and then even more reflection here with our tin foil. Next, we are going to use our black paper. And I have two pieces of black paper with the tissue paper on, whichever way you made it. And we're going to place them in the center of our pizza box. And I'm going to use tape to tape them down. Now, why did we just put black construction paper into our pizza box solar cooker? Well, it turns out that when sun rays come into our pizza box, it reflects off of the aluminum foil and then hits the black construction paper. And because it's black, it absorbs the heat, so then it increases the temperature inside the box when we're cooking in it. So that means that our cheese on our nachos will melt faster and the chocolate on our s'mores will melt faster as well. So it's really good to have this black construction paper. Hi Girl Scouts, thanks so much for joining me in my backyard. Now is the moment of truth. We are going to see if our pizza box solar cooker works. And so what we're gonna do is we're going to open up our pizza box and we are going to put our food, in my case nachos, on the center of our black pieces of paper. And then we are going to close the pizza box. Now I brought out my tape so that I could tape the sides of my box closed just to make sure that it's pretty airtight. I'll do that really quick so that it doesn't pop open. Great. Next, we are going to see what angle our lid should be to have the most sunlight hitting it and reflecting down into our pizza box. And I have my stick here. It looks like if we put it at this angle, that would be best. And I'm going to tape my stick onto my box so that it stays put, just like so. So now we wait. And this can take up to an hour to 2 hours, depending on how bright and reflective your sun is. So let's go back inside and we'll learn about the science as to how exactly this works. Thank you so much for joining me back inside. Alrighty, so now we have to think about why exactly is our pizza box solar cooker melting cheese on top of our chips to create delicious nachos? Well, first, we have to think about what our energy source is. And I'll give you a hint. It's really big in our solar system. You can see it in the sky and it's really bright. It also happens to be about 93.354 million miles away from the Earth. You got it, it's the sun. The sun is the energy source that is providing heat to melt our cheese. So I drew a little diagram here to give you a little bit better of a visual. So, the sun produces ultraviolet rays, and these rays hit Earth at an angle. Now, some of these rays are hitting our pizza box right in the center of it, so that it's melting the cheese directly. Now, there's other rays that are missing our pizza box, but some of the rays that would otherwise miss our pizza box is hitting tin foil and dropping down, that tinfoil reflects the sun rays down into our box to continue heating our nachos. So that's why we have the extra flap with tinfoil to create more heat so that our nachos can be delicious. Now, a really important piece to our pizza box is that plastic wrap. And the plastic wrap holds heat inside of our box so that it can increase the temperature and make the sun rays that go into our box especially useful. So that's a little bit of the science behind what we did today. Alrighty, well, the moment has come to test and see if our pizza box solar cooker worked. Now, this has been out here for about 1 hour and 7 minutes, and it looks like the cheese has melted. So I'll open it up and I'll give you a look. Yay! So great! Here are our nachos, and they are in fact melted just a little bit. I'm so excited to eat this later. It's going to be totally delicious. Well, I would just like to congratulate everyone on achieving the goals that we set today. We did in fact make a pizza box solar cooker. We planned a meal, or in this case, a snack to put in our pizza box. And we used the power of the sun to heat up the cheese to make delicious nachos, and it worked. We also learned about the science as to why exactly a pizza box solar cooker works. So great job, y'all did wonderful. Now, if you want to take this even a step further, the Junior Eco Camper badge encourages you to learn about the 7 Leave No Trace principles. And if you want to take it even a step further than that, we challenge you to make a skit showcasing the 7 Leave No Trace principles. And you could even have fun with it and do a live video conference call with your troop and perform your Leave No Trace skit. So thank you so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it. If you're looking for some more at-home activities, please visit our Girl Scouts page at girlscouts.org. You can also visit our shop there on our website as well. Or if you want some other resources, feel free to connect with your local troop leader and your council. So thank you so much for joining me today, and we'll see you next time.